Today, I'm going to give you the three most important tips on how to choose the right external storage device for your needs. Hi, my name is Chris, and I'm with CRU, and when it comes to finding good, fast external storage for your data, finding the right setup for your computer can often be a huge hurdle, so I'm here to help you with that. When we're talking about external storage, we are talking about things as common as portable hard drives that you can order from any retail store to more complex things like external RAID boxes and storage systems that can be mounted in your company's server room's rack mount cases. When you transfer data, there's always going to be a chain of components that your data must pass through in order to get to its intended destination. This chain starts with the media where your data is stored and ends at the computer or workstation that it's plugged into. So let's look at a specific example and say you have an external USB 3.0 drive enclosure. The data chain goes from the data on the drive inside to the drive's interface to the external enclosure to the USB 3.0 interface in the enclosure, and from there through a USB 2.0 cable to the USB 2.0 interface on the computer. USB 3.0 is backwards compatible with USB 2.0, so you may think you're getting the USB 3.0 speed of 5 gigabits per second for your data transfer, but the slowest component sets the pace. And if we look at the speed of the USB 2.0 cable, you'll see that the speed of your data transfer drops right off a cliff. If the equipment you already have limits the speed of your data transfers with the fastest external drives, then getting the fastest external drive won't be a wise use of money. The slowest component sets the pace. Next, you'll have to consider how you'll be using your external storage. If you're backing up or editing photos or video, you'll want an enclosure with RAID that copies data to one or more drives inside the enclosure. If you're on the go, then you'll want a portable enclosure that does the same thing, like our Tough Tech Duo. If you need extra speed, perhaps if you're editing Ultra HD video or are using a program that accesses the drive a lot, consider using solid-state drives inside your enclosure. You may not need the speed of an SSD, however. The price per gigabyte of SSDs is much more expensive than with standard hard drives. So if you're only using the enclosure for backups, use standard drives, since an SSD's blazing speed isn't needed. In short, you can save yourself some cash by purchasing the simplest solution for your needs. The USB 3.1 Gen 2 specification defines three aspects that change how we think about external storage and other devices connected to our computers. The first is the data transfer rate of 10 gigabits per second, twice as fast as USB 3.0. USB 3.1 also brings with it the flippable Type-C universal connector. The Type-C connector has no up or down orientation, so there's no more guesswork on which way to plug in your USB Type-C cable. Next is the ability to deliver power to any device that it's plugged into, including an external hard drive. It can even power a laptop that's running low on battery power. That's just one example of how USB 3.1 minimizes the number of cables you have to use in order to operate a computer. As time goes on, many more devices and manufacturers will implement USB 3.1. Your data is also important to us here at CRU, and our business is to help you retain that data and to access it in a way that helps best serve your particular needs. Keep these three tips in mind, and you'll be well on your way towards finding the best external storage for your needs. We've also written a white paper that includes four more tips. So if you want more information, click on the link for that white paper down in the description below. And if you haven't already, please subscribe to get access to more product spotlights, computer tips, and more information on upcoming products right here on youtube.com/digitalcru. Thanks for watching.